Welcome children. Today we shall start from question number 10 of the chapter Lines and Angles of class 7 NCERT. Let us read the question. Indicate which pairs of angles are vertically opposite, linear pair. These two we have to do. And this figure is given to you. I have drawn this figure two times, for one for this part, another for this part. So let us start first this one. Now here we have to find out the pair of vertically opposite angles. So what we have learned about vertically opposite angles, that when two lines intersect, pair of opposite angles are equal. Say, see here, this is one line and this is another line intersecting at this point. So pair of opposite angles are equal, matlab angle 4 is equal to angle 1 and angle 5 is equal to angle 2 plus 3. So we will write here, angle 1 is equal to angle 4 and angle 5 is equal to angle 2 plus angle 3. Reason, when two lines intersect, pair of opposite angles are equal. Understood? Now coming to the second part, we have to indicate the linear pair of angles. See the word pair. Pair means we are talking of only two angles. Linear pair means the angles should be adjacent and some should be 180 degree. So now you see here this straight line. This is a straight line. And the angle is 180 degree straight angle. So one linear pair becomes 5 plus 4. So angles forming a linear pair are, first is 5 plus 4. Angle 5 plus angle 4. Now second pair you see. Second pair it is angle 5 and angle 1. You see here, this is the straight line. The angle formed is straight angle, that is 180 degree. So another linear pair is angle 5 and angle 1. So our second part is angle 5 plus angle 1. Alright. So this completes this question. Now come to question number 11. What do we see here? The question says, in the following figure, is angle 1 adjacent to angle 2? And we have to give the reason. Now see here, angle 1 is here. This is angle 1. Okay. And angle 2 is here. This is angle 2. So if the angles are adjacent, the first point is they have a common arm. When we are talking of this angle, this arm comes. And when we are talking of this angle, this arm comes. But next point is common vertex. Here you see, they have two different vertices. Angle 1 has this vertex and angle 2 has this vertex. So angle 1 and angle 2 are not adjacent. We write here angle 2 and angle 1 are not adjacent because they do not have a common vertex. Understood? Yeah, I made a mistake here. See, angle 1 is not equal to angle 2. Angle 1 and angle 2 are not adjacent because they do not have a common vertex. Angle 1 and angle 2 are not adjacent because they do not have a common vertex. These two vertices are different. Understood? Now question number 12, find the values of x, y and z in each of the following. See here the figure is given. Now we have to find the value of x, we have to find the value of y and we have to find the value of z. Now see, this is 55, so this will be also 55. Why? Because when two lines intersect, pair of opposite angles are equal. So here angle x is equal to 55 degree because they are vertically opposite angles. They are vertically opposite angles, and vertically opposite angles are equal when two lines intersect. Okay, now we have come to know that this angle is 55 degree. Now see here, 55 degree plus z is equal to 180 degree because linear pair. So now 55 degree plus z is equal to 180, they form linear pair. Okay, so z is equal to what? 180 degree minus 55. This comes when this shifts its side, this side, it becomes 180 minus 55 degree. So 10 minus 5 is 5, 7 minus 5 is 2, and 125 degree. So angle z is 125 degree. Now see here again, z is 125, so y is also 125. Why? Again that same reason, when two lines intersect, pair of opposite angles are equal, means z and y are vertically opposite. Here now angle z is equal to angle y, so angle y is equal to 125 degree. Reason, pair of vertically opposite angles are equal. Now starting the second part of the question, here also we have to find the value of x, y and z. Now look at the figure. We have to find z. We know this angle as 40 degree. This as 25 degree. Now see here. When two lines intersect, pair of opposite angles are equal. It means z is equal to 40 degree. So we write here, angle z is equal to 40 degree. Reason, pair of vertically opposite angles are equal. Fine. Now you see here. So you got this as 40 degree. Now see, this is forming a linear pair. This is straight angle. This one. So 40 plus y is equal to 180. So we write here. Now 40 degree plus y, angle y is equal to 180 degree. Why? Linear pair of angles. So angle y is equal to what? 180 degree minus 40 degree. This comes this side. When side changes, sign changes. Here it is plus 40. When it comes this side, it becomes minus 40. So this is equal to 140 degree. So angle y is 140 degree. Okay, now you see here, this one, 40 degree plus x plus 25, this is equal to 180 degree. Why? Because it is a, see, straight angle. So now 40 degree plus x plus 25 degree is equal to 180 degree. So 40 plus 25 is 65 degree. X plus 65 degree is equal to 180 degree. Now what is x? 180 degree minus 65, which is equal to 115 degree. So we have calculated angle x is equal to 115 degree. Angle y is equal to 140 degree. And angle z is equal to 40 degree. Understood? So this completes the question. Next question is question number 14. In the adjoining figure, name the following pairs of angles. We have to name the following pairs of angles. First is vertically obtuse, vertically opposite angles. Now we have to find out obtuse and vertically opposite. So let us see here. When two lines intersect, this is the first line. and this is the second line. When two lines intersect, pair of opposite angles are equal. Now this angle and this angle are vertically opposite, but these two are what? Acute angles. We have to find out obtuse. Now see which one is the other. This is the obtuse angle and this is the obtuse angle. So this angle is AOD and angle BOC. So we write here vertically opposite obtuse angles are angle AOD and angle BOC. Okay, now coming to the second part. This is the second part. We have to find adjacent complementary angles. So complementary angles means some should be 90. Complementary means some should be 90. So let us see here, this one, see here, some is 90. And if we take this as the common arm, these two angles become adjacent angles. AOB, OA comes, OA is the common, O is the common vertex, OA is the common arm. OB and OE are on the either side. So adjacent complementary angles are BOA and EOA. Okay, so we write here adjacent complementary angles are angle AOB and angle AOE. AOB and AOE. Okay. Next part is equal supplementary angles. See here, the word supplementary angles means sum of two angles must be 180 degree, and word equal means those two angles must be equal. So let us see in this figure. In this figure, what do you see here? See, this angle is 90. Again, this angle is 90. Means both the angles are equal, and the sum here is 180 degree. So equal supplementary angles are BOE and DOP. Understood? So equal supplementary angles are angle BOE and angle DOE. Understood? Okay. Now coming to the fourth part. Now see here, in the fourth part it is given unequal supplementary angles. Again, supplementary angles means sum is 180, and unequal means both the angles are not equal. So now see here, this one, this is a straight angle. Sum of these two angles is 180 degree, and this angle is not equal to this angle. So these two angles are unequal supplementary angles. So what are unequal supplementary angles in this? Angle DOC and angle BOC. So unequal supplementary angles are angle BOC and angle DOC. Got it? Now coming to the fifth part. Adjacent angles that do not form a linear pair. Means the two angles should be adjacent and they should not a linear pair. Matlab, sum of two angles should not be 180 degree. So we will choose here. See here, this one. Choose this one. Here these two angles are adjacent and the sum of these two angles is not 180 degree. So we say angle BOA and angle EOA are adjacent angles that do not form a linear pair. So angle BOA, this angle BOA and angle EOA. EOA form a pair of adjacent angles which do not form a linear pair. Okay, this completes this question. Now let's start question number 13. Now 14th I had first done, and now I'm doing the 13th one because it was fill in the blanks. I wanted to work out the questions first. Now fill in the blanks. If two angles are complementary, then sum of their measures is 90 degree. Complementary angles, the sum is always 90. Now if two angles are supplementary, then sum of their measures is 180 degree. Sum of two complementary angles is always 180 degree. Now see here, if two angles forming a linear pair are the two angles which form a linear pair, they are what? Forming 180 degree, so they are supplementary. Now if two adjacent angles are supplementary, see, these are two adjacent angles, and if they are supplementary, so what they are forming? They are forming a linear pair. They form a linear pair. Okay. Now if two lines intersect at a point, see here, two lines intersecting at a point, then vertically opposite angles are equal. This is equal to this and this is equal to this. Now sixth part. If two lines intersect at a point, two lines, these are intersecting at a point, and one pair of vertically opposite angles are acute. This is acute. Then other pair of vertically opposite angles are, this is obtuse. Understood, children? So with this, we complete the exercise 5.1. Clear? In the next class, we shall start with intersecting lines and parallel lines. Okay? Wish you all the best. Thank you.